Hello everyone, I am Dr. M. Sharada Varalakshmi, Professor, St. Peter's Engineering College, Hyderabad. Today I am going to explain you about the contents of mobile communication. In this discussion, we will be generally looking into mobile computing, the novel applications of mobile devices, the location-dependent services of a mobile environment, effects of device portability, the differences between a wireless network and a fixed network, the limitations of wireless networks, and a simple reference model or architecture of a mobile application. The goals of mobile computing. Why we need a mobile computing at all? People are at different locations and they want to communicate with each other easily and securely. To have this easy and secured methodology, we need to get introduced to something called as mobile communication. Here we not only share the voice between each other, we also share data, image and video or multimedia between people or between the devices. This sharing can be at any time, anywhere in a timely and cost-effective way. This is the goal why a mobile computing device has been introduced. And now coming to why mobile computing and how this mobile computing actually works. This mobile computing refers to computing in a distributed system. Distributed system, otherwise we call it as a client-server computing system, in which some processes or processor can move. In this moving process, the logical mobility, which is realized by agents, and moving process is other type, physical mobility realized by mobile devices. Also, mobile computing extends a distributed computing environment with a new dimension of mobility. Here, new dimension of mobility means that this mobile communicating systems are based on client-server computing systems. And recently, mobile computing solutions consider general distributing environment where peer-to-peer computing environments is possible. And generally, many mobile computing techniques have their root in distributed systems. What a distributed system and what a client-server technology is already aware to you, where a server gets connected to number of clients and whatever app or whatever communication you need will be brought from the server to the clients. So this environment is called as a distributed system or a distributed environment, which enables various resources to access the server, and the server grants the resources to the devices or systems. Okay, it is multiple autonomous components. Components are not shared by all users in this distributed environment. Resources may not be accessible to all the devices in this distributed environment. Software runs in concurrent processes on different processors in a distributed system. Okay, this mobile computing also uses a distributed system, as we have discussed just now, where a service provider acts as a server and all these mobile devices are connected to the service provider to get access to various apps or various applications provided by the provider. Wirelessly only, we are very specific here. When we call it as a device is always a mobile device or a wireless device. Both the terms are used interchangeably. Okay. The mobile device distributed system is generally a decentralized computation on a diversified devices, systems and networks, which are mobile, synchronized and interconnected via a certain mobile communication standards and protocols. Now, we are going to discuss about what are the devices what we use in mobile communication. One here, two steps of devices. One is user mobility and the other one is device portability. User mobility is generally a user who is getting communicated wirelessly may keep on moving anytime, anywhere, with anyone, at any place. So this mobility should be considered. And the device, your laptop or a wireless LAN or a mobile device, this device also may be moving from one place to other, getting connected from a remote place anytime, anywhere to the network. So these are the two things what we need to consider when we are talking about mobile communication. Here, as you can see in the slide here, a communication device can exhibit in one of the following characteristics. Either it may be fixed or wired network, like a typical desktop computer you find in your labs, or a mobile and a wired, example is your laptop, a fixed and a wireless device, example is your wireless LAN, And the other characteristic is what you are using in your hands today is a mobile and wireless device. Example is your mobile phone. So when these types of characteristics a device is possessing, generally then there may be some certain issues. Those issues we are discussing here, mobility issues. The main issue is the definitely a bandwidth restriction and variability, and location aware network operation. See, you may move from one location to other location. Automatically the network moves from one location to the other location. So the network will have to be it will have to locate where you are first. This is a location aware network, we call it. This is a dynamic replication. Every second you keep moving from one place to the other place, again a dynamic replication of data should be there. This is one major issue. And sometimes busy network activity during connections and handling, disconnections may happen because of your handover mechanism. Disconnections may take place, and disconnection of OS and file system issues may occur, allows for disconnected operation. Database system issues may occur when disconnection takes place. See, all these issues must be addressed when we are talking about mobile communication. Each of these problem is addressed, we'll be discussing in our further units or further classes. And the other one is portability issues of your mobile device. Battery power restrictions, definitely we are all facing this battery power restriction because of our portability. And physical damage or loss and theft of our mobile device, that also we all have faced this problem. Unauthorized access, an unknown person may access your mobile device. Encrypted data stored on mobiles, data should always be secured, so encrypted data should be stored on the mobile. And backup critical data to fixed hosts. Always a backup of the data should be taken place. Even though there is a theft, you can always recover the data from the backup device. These are the different portability issues which may occur due to this mobile devices. Now we are going to see how this mobile device has actually evolved. Analog systems, 1G, 2G, 2.5G, 3G systems. That is, first generation used only analog systems of mobile devices. The second generation used voice communications and circuit switching. As you know, by the time we came to third generation and say fourth generation, we are using only packet switching. But the second generation always used circuit switched networks. Now, by the time it has come to 2.5G, 2.5 generations, circuit switching for voice, and whenever there is a data communication, only packet switching for data. And by the time it came to the third generation, packet switching for voice, they have started using packet switching for voice and data, and speed has improved, and compatibility with different technologies has also come into existence by the time it came to third generation systems. And evolution of this, the continuation. Now we are also seeing 4G systems, 3.5G systems have also come, where radio interface has come into existence. IP based core network has come into existence. Compatibility with different access technologies has come into existence. 4G systems have come. Lately, everybody knows all your mobile devices are today 4G systems only. 4G systems have come into existence where new air interface is taking place. Very high bit rate services is taking place. Convergence of wireless and IP worlds has taken, your internet services and all also, your Gmail services, everything you are able to use in your mobile device. This is how, as we have discussed, this is only a tabular form of how these generations have, how the mobile computing has evolved through generations. As you can see here, voice and data are the two parameters what we have considered, and how this 2G, early 3G, late 3G and 4G services have come into existence. What we have discussed in the previous slide is actually put into a tabular form here. Novel applications of your mobile communication. See, everything we are almost everything. Today's generation is using all these novel applications of mobile communications. You are using your mobile communication in your vehicles in the form of transmission of news, roads conditions, weather, You are also predicting the weather. You are also knowing where the traffic is. If at all the traffic is in the location where you are going, you are immediately changing your, you are taking a diversion and going into a trafficless area or passing through a trafficless area. Okay, you are using your positioning through GPS. You are able to understand the addresses without inquiring. Previously, what used to happen? We used to stop somewhere and inquire with someone, or show them the address and actually go to that particular location. Now through GPS, you need not stop anywhere, or you need not ask anybody about the addresses and all. You are directly using this GPS, you are able to go to that location. Okay, you local ad hoc network with vehicles close by to prevent accidents. See, ad hoc, when we discuss this ad hoc network, I'll generally explain you about the architecture of this ad hoc network. Due to this ad hoc network, we are generally knowing how accidents are taking place. We are able to prevent accidents due to these ad hoc networks. And vehicular data is also transmitted in advance for maintenance. Other application is emergency. You all know 108. There is an ambulance where in the ambulance you have a mobile device where the condition of the patient is explained to the doctor where you are taking the patient to the hospital, and the doctor will be ready with all the equipment by the time this ambulance reaches that particular hospital and doctor. First aid or immediately he can be attended, and some sort of diagnosis will be done for that patient. So early transmission of patient data to the hospital current status helps in first diagnosis. And almost everywhere we can see replacement of fixed infrastructure to a mobile device in case of earthquakes and hurricanes, etc., fires, etc. Okay, traveling salesman. This is once again a wonderful example of traveling salesman, a wonderful example of your mobile communication. You can directly access to customer files stored in the central location. Consistent databases for all agents and mobile office. Another novel application is all the fixed networks are now converted into a wireless networks. There are remote sensors everywhere. You are able to predict the weather. You are able to predict tsunamis. You are able to predict earthquakes. Sitting at your location, you are able to access the stock market. You are doing certain trades using with the help of these mobile applications. Okay, all the lands in the historic buildings are being converted into mobile applications or wireless applications these days. You are using your mobile devices by using internet. In this quarantine, you are able to actually communicate, talk to each other. You are playing tambola, you are playing ludos, you are accessing internet, you are having Zoom classes. All this is because of this mobile devices or mobile revolution or mobile application. Now we are going to see what location dependent services are. There are a few services what our mobile communication or mobile computing supports us. One service is location aware service, follow on service, information service, support service, and privacy. Once coming to the location aware service, I'll go back to my example, which I always tell. What services are location aware? Printer, fax, phone, server, etc. exists in local environment. Let us go back to my example. Suppose you are in a hotel, you are in the fifth floor, you are working on your laptop, and you are supposed to immediately take a printer and you are supposed to leave the hotel. But your printer is not available in your particular room. It's somewhere in the ground floor. So it's a location aware service. You can as well give a print option from your laptop, and remotely a printer is connected somewhere in the ground floor. And just while you are leaving the hotel, you can go to the ground floor, you can shut down your laptop, you can give a print option, you can shut down your laptop, you can carry your briefcase, you can go down, take a print there, and you can leave the hotel. This service is called as location aware service. That is, wirelessly the printer is connected to your laptop, and you are able to wirelessly give a command to the printer, and you are able to collect the printout and you are able to leave. And a fax. These days we are not using our fax machines, but previously we used to have a fax machine where you can send a document, a copy of the document from one location to the other. This is the best example what you can talk about location aware service. And follow on service. Every mobile device you all know today is having a call forward, call recording, call forwarding, call hold. All these are called as follow on services, where automatic call forwarding, transmission of the actual workspace to the current location. So this is a follow on service we call. And information service, push based and pull based services are information services. Push based, suppose you go to a supermarket, you buy something, and while billing, he'll generally ask you to give your phone number. You give the phone number, and once you start, once you come back home, you keep on receiving some or the other message from the supermarket that so and so offer is there, 50% discount on some chocolates, 10% discount on so and so. You please immediately come and take it. All these are without your knowledge. They are just pushing off all the SMS, all the messages to your mobile device. So this message is, this service is called as push service. And some services are called pull based services. Suppose you want to access your bank account, you want to withdraw some amount, or you want to transfer some amount from one account to the other account, then we call it as a pull service. You are demanding it, so we call it as pull service or on demand service. Push service, without any demand, automatically the server is sending you some messages, then we call it as a push service. The other one is a support service. Support services where the intermediate result, suppose state information, follow on services, for example, through a fixed device, you are able to store some data into your mobile device, or sometimes you keep there is a cache in your cache memory in your mobile where some of the messages are stored in this. That device, that services are about your billing, about your payment, about your memory of your mobile, about the overflow of your memory, and all these are called as support services. And the other one is privacy. Privacy, while doing all this, in spite of so many services, the most important thing what you should have in your mobile device is privacy. So along with this, the mobile device also helps you to secure your data. Okay, effects of device portability. So the previous slide we have seen what are the different services provided by the mobility, and here we are seeing the effects of device portability. One is power consumption. We are all facing this problem. Continuously you keep using, downloading number of apps, automatically the consumption of your mobile decreases. Okay, and loss of data due to high portability. In advance into the design, there may be a loss of data or theft of your mobile device, etc. Limited user interfaces. Compromise between size of fingers and portability is the limited user interface. Integration of a character, voice recognition, abstract symbols, etc. is also limited. And as I told you just now, limited memory. As it's a mobile device, now these days you have got 32 GB, but previously we used to have only 4 GB or 8 GB in your mobile device, which is a limited memory. This is also one of the effect of device portability. Now, wireless networks in comparison with fixed networks. As we know, what a fixed network is, we have kept on seeing through the years. These days we are using only wireless networks. So we'll just compare how a wireless network and fixed network are in. So higher loss rates due to the interference. Yes, definitely there will be because of interferences in the wireless network, there may be a loss of data. Packet recovery is generally very difficult. And restrictive regulations of frequencies. Generally, we always face this problem. The end-to-end communication may not be there, or loss of packets, drop of packets in between the network may be because of this wireless networks, which we don't find in a fixed network. And low transmission rates due to local, some megabits per second, regional currently 53 kbits with GSM. Local transmission rates are very low here. in a wireless network. And higher delays and higher jitter. Connection setup may take time. Range may be very less in wireless networks. This may be a major drawback of wireless networks, but these days the services are have improved a lot, and wireless network is at par with any other fixed network. And definitely when we are talking about wireless network, there is a problem of always a drop of packets, and otherwise we call it as attacks in between. In security related problems may occur. Lower security is there because always there are hackers in between the wireless network. This may be a major problem of wireless network devices. And this is a very old subscriber information we have, 2008, according to 2008. These are the different subscribers who are using mobile phones. Yeah, another limitation of this mobile environment is limitation of wireless network. Fragmented networks, as we have already known that. Frequent disconnections, we all know, hello, 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 we keep on saying it. Sometimes the voice from the other side is not clear. Sometimes there are some distortions in the mobile. And sometimes there is a cut in the phone when you are talking. All these are the limitations of wireless networks. Lack of mobility awareness sometimes, breakages in the network. Because you keep on moving from one place to the other, dynamic changes in the communication environment. Sometimes there is a short battery life and limited capacities of the bit ratio. This is the simple reference model what we see of a mobile device, mobile environment. As you can see, our regular OSI model has got 7 layers, but our mobile layer or our wireless layer is mainly concentrates on only these layers: physical layer, data link layer, network layer, transport layer, and application layer. Whereas the physical layer is a radio layer, we call it, or a physical medium, we call it. Data link layer, you all know, for the transmission of data, the data link layer. Network layer is generally, whenever we think about, routing, how the routing takes place. Transport layer, end-to-end protocol, end-to-end transmission is taking place in the transmission layer or transport layer. Application layer are the different apps what you use to get connected from one mobile location to the other mobile location. Here in the general OSI layer, you generally find 7 layers, but in our mobile device, we are only talking about these 5 layers on either side. Maybe from the mobile to the mobile, maybe from a mobile to the desktop, or from a mobile to another laptop which is wirelessly connected. So this is a simple reference model what we are going to see in our future classes. So this is the functionality, as I just told you now. These are the different layers. We all are very much familiar with all the functions of each of these layers. When we talk about physical layer, we talk about the modulation, interference, attenuation, and frequency of the device in the mobile environment. Data link